Our roving reporter, Danny Teece-Johnson, is in Broome in Western Australia tonight. He's looking at the ongoing story over the planned closure of 150 communities and also the deregistration of the Burrup sacred site. Danny, what can you tell us?
Yeah, g'day, Natty. Good to have you back on the desk. I'm back out here in beautiful Broome, although not so beautiful at the moment with some of the language being used by our politicians. Of note, Rachel Siewert, the Greens WA Senator, is in town today. She's the National Spokesman on Aboriginal Affairs for the Greens. So in terms of her counterparts, Liberal and Labor, she's the Shane Newman and the Nigel Scullion of Indigenous Affairs. Now, the Senator's pretty upset. I've got to say, I've interviewed her just before about the deregistration of the Burrup as a sacred site and what that means. Now, I've talked to locals here today. They're just over in this building over here at the moment having a consultation meeting with the Senator and just basically telling her how they feel about what's going on with the community closures up here. So she used some strong language. So let's throw to an early interview I did with Rachel Siewert, the Greens WA Senator.
Well, I have been up here with the Health Committee talking to communities around Aboriginal health issues, but I've specifically now come here and I'll be going to Fitzroy Crossing to talk about community closures and the proposals by the WA government to close communities. Or I think what they'll probably do is more strangle them by restricting resources and services to the point where people will have to drift away in order to get services. I think they'll be much more sneaky about it. So I want to talk firsthand to the people that are affected so that then I can help reflect their opinions both to broader Australia, in the media, and particularly to the Senate.
Now, I retweeted one of your tweets the other day that the WA government has deregistered the Burrup as a sacred site. Now, there was a collective eye roll around Aboriginal Australia when we heard about this, and I know you remarked it's one of the most embarrassing things you've ever seen in WA Parliament. Can you tell us a little bit about the process for that decision and how a government can deregister a sacred site?
Well, there's a number of aspects to this process. First off, the state government is busy, I call it, undermining and totally changing the Heritage Act in WA to devalue Aboriginal heritage. That's what I think that they're doing. And certainly Robin Chappell, who's one of our Greens members of the Legislative Council, has been working on that issue tirelessly. But what they're also doing is redefining what a sacred site is. So they're now saying it has to be of religious significance. They're saying it just can't be mythological story, song or belief. In other words, totally undermining what a site means. And so they're saying, well, therefore, that Burrup isn't of ongoing religious significance now. And so therefore, and again, totally putting it in a totally separate context to Aboriginal Aboriginal beliefs and why sites have significance. So they're totally reinterpreting that in order to drop a lot of sites, and unfortunately the Burrup's not the only site that they have dropped off. There's a list and I believe they'll be dropping off more.
Can you tell us some of those other sites that are potentially up for deregistration?
So at this stage we haven't seen the sites that they intend to drop off, but there's some I know around the Swan Valley that I've been talking to people around down there. You'll find that there's sites all over Western Australia, and I think that it will come as no surprise that this government is a facilitator of the oil and gas industry and other mining ventures. And I bet you, if you look really carefully, you'll see what's driving this. And of course, we know that there's been issues before getting clearance for them to go and trash sacred sites to facilitate mining. And you can bet your bottom dollar that that's exactly what they want to do.
And Danny, you're heading out to the communities tomorrow. Tell us where you're going and who will you be speaking to?
Yeah, that's right, Natty. Once we're finished here, I'll pack up my kit and caboodle and head to the airport. I'm going to head out to Fitzroy Crossing this afternoon with the Senator, and then tomorrow morning head out to Wonkajunka Aboriginal community. It's one of the communities under threats. It's the very famous Olive Knight lives out there and her son Nelson Beyondiri. So we're going to catch up with those guys again. And they looked after us last time, and we're pleased to be able to get back out there again. And I guess what the people up here in the Kimberley are telling me that this is the community closures is all about the oil and gas. It's not about Aboriginal people or Aboriginal culture. And those words have been reiterated by Rachel Siewert. So I'll talk to you tomorrow, Natty. So that's all from me and Broome. Welcome back on the desk. Good to see you. And thanks to our partners here at Galari Media for helping us out today. Appreciate it, especially you, Arthur.
Thank you very much, Danny Teece-Johnson in Broome there, and safe travels for tomorrow, Danny.